Hi, this is Rich, WB5YBZ. I thought I'd make just a full wave loop or a delta loop for 20 meters. I think it's going to work on 10 meters too. Haven't tried it yet, but let me go over to the computer and let me show you what I've sort of deducted and trying to figure out. So let's go on over there, and thanks so much for watching. Okay, here's what according to my friend John, N5ID, he said really for a full wave loop, 936 divided frequency in megahertz is probably the best one. And so I'm figuring about 14.2 megahertz. So I divided that into 936, and I come out to about 65.9 feet, and which is about 65 feet and 10 inches. Now, what I'm using here, John said if the N5ID said if you're close to the ground, the impedance really is better with a 2.5:1 instead of a 4:1. But a 4:1 will work if you have it. One thing I would suggest, if you order it from Ballon Design, this is a Ballon Design. John had him put extra eye bolts in both sides, so he loaned me his 2.5 Ballon. He wasn't using it, and I also used one of the S hooks. You can see it almost looks like an S. I use these with the lawn stuff. You can go to some lawn and garden place like Hello's and Home Depot, Walmart, and you can find these maybe 2 feet long, a foot long, whatever. And what I thought is, what if I hook it to the S hook to the gutter, and then just have insulators on? You can make it at any size. You can make this longer out or shorter or whatever, depending on your room. And this would almost be a good stealth antenna. I'm not sure by the streets what it would look like. I got some hooks from Walmart that are orange, but they're easily seen. They do have some black hooks, would be less seen. But here's my Ballon, and I'm hooking this up here. And I had to cut a little bit off, even though I had 10 inches. Imagine I have a sort of a smaller wire. I forgot what size it was. Maybe a thicker wire might give you a little different SWR. But if you want to cut a little extra longer, and you can always cut off. It's a lot easier to cut off than it is to try to put it back on. So let's go outside and just show you what I got set up. As you can see, I had the S hook, and I tried to hook it to where it's mounted, pretty close to where it's mounted, so I wouldn't pull down on the gutter too much. Here's my Ballon, and I have about 50 foot of coax going to it as well. But it's going over there, and then coming over here to this. I got these stakes at Walmart. They're for staking tents down. I think they were like $2 or less a piece. So let me back up so you can just sort of see the whole situation. Right over there is one insulator. I put my insulators in there, but I was going to tie them off. I thought, well, if I had a higher roof, I could probably tie it off with strings. And then it comes down here to where this one is, and then it goes up to the Ballon. And of course, the Ballon from here, it goes on over to this one over here. Well, I just don't know how it's going to work. I have up to the Ballon up there, it's about 8.5 feet. But then you look at about a third of it is laying just on top of the grass. Just on top of the grass. So 8 feet high. Let's just see how the 7300 does on 100 watts. Well, without the antenna tuner on, this is what I'm getting. I don't know if you can see. Everything's really below 2 on from 344 to
24. And to almost 1,400 to 122, it's still below 2. You probably could cut some more off to get it more in the band. Whiskey Bravo 5, Yankee Bravo Zanzibar.
Whiskey Bravo 5, Yankee Bravo Zulu, got you on the list, sir. Anybody else for late check-ins or last calls for the Ole Miss 20-meter net, please call now. Yankee Bravo Zulu, Richard in Oklahoma, any copy on November 0, Juliet Oscar Yankee?
Yes, you're 5'9", sounding really, really strong here in Oklahoma City. The name is Rich. You got me, Richard. I just go by Rich, and I just want to check in. I put up a little delta loop. Part of it's laying on the grass, and you're 5'9". I was just wondering, running 100 watts with a 7300, wondering if you could tell me how my signal strength is. I sure would appreciate it. Back to net control.
All right, well, I copy your 5'9", sir, and I've also got you 5'9" here in Glendale, Arizona, and the call here is November 0, Juliet Oscar Yankee. I say again, N0JOY. Roger, roger.
Roger, roger. N0JOY. Thanks so much. WB5YBZ.
Wow, Glendale, Arizona. According to Google, that's about, probably straight as a crow flies, probably about 900 miles, but still, that's 900 miles. Let's look at some of the waterfalls and see what we're listening to, and let's go on back over to the 7300.
I'm here, Phoenix, Arizona, calling CQ20 and W9 Mike, Romeo Charlie.
I'm listening
first.
Up and down, up and down. My name is Charlie, and I'm in Panama City, Florida.
Okay, there's Florida.
Just on and on and on. Noriega. America.
I don't know what that's all about, but. Probably South America or Mexico.
I don't really know how to explain it, but yeah, you're about a 5 and 7 here into Michigan, Mike India, over.
Michigan.
Miles an hour, and they were in an SUV. I don't know if it was a woman or a guy.
What's that?
Probably Mexico or South America.
We showed up with no visa.
And it was the last flight in. The plane took off to go back. They don't overnight in the country. And they said I had to spend that. They took my passport. Said I'd have to spend the night in a chair in the airport in Maputo, which was not very much fun. That's typical old communist country stuff. But fortunately, somebody in the embassy took pity on me. They called four or five of the main guys. I don't think the ambassador came.
I was like, oh, that's good. I'm glad. This made my day. They were driving like idiots.
Almost every night up there.
What's going on in the world? I have no idea, but in Afghanistan, you always heard that the opium trade was funding the Taliban, and it did to a certain extent. And it was.
Let's try 10 meters. I don't know if I'm going to hit the. Looks like it's deader than a doornail. Don't even hear any beacons.
secretly building up nuclear power, so it's not unconceivable.
Let's see. Can't tune 15.
Fantastic. I'm doing about a kilowatt here, about 1,000 watts, and the driver is an ICOM 7700. The antenna is a two-element step IR. And I tell you what, I'm got...
Too high SWR to tune in. Just with the tuner for the 7300, but 20 meters, it seems like it's cooking pretty good. Not sure.
Tango, Florida, Joke 4, X6DT.
Anyway, you can see that the band's doing pretty good. So let's see, it's about 5:30 in the evening here in Oklahoma. So thanks so much for watching. I'll catch you later.